Namaste. D-Long here, Seer Ashlamaz, and I wanted to speak to you for a minute, drop some lyrics on you about stroke. You know, that's something that a lot of our people have to deal with in the past and these days as well. And it's not a joke. It's a very serious thing, and we need to be more aware of it, you know. Our blood pressure, systolic and diastolic, are very important, just as much as the pulse and the blood sugar. But stroke is very, I would say, sinister because it's so silent. You know, I suffered a TIA stroke in 2017, approximately March 6th. And, you know, everybody that experiences a stroke is not as fortunate as myself, you know, and I'm thankful to the Most High that I am still here and able to talk about it, and from an active standpoint, not a vegetative state. You know, it is extremely important that we really take care of ourselves and pay attention to what we're putting in our mouths, because it does build up over time, you know, and the GMO foods, the heavy smoking, the not exercising, the stressful lifestyles, you know, these are things that are contributing factors that almost guarantee a person is going to have a stroke. So what I normally do tell people when we're in conversation and they say, you know, I might say, yeah, I suffered a stroke. You know, they'd be like, oh, I'm so sorry. I'd be like, oh, no, I was practicing for it. You know, I was eating salty stuff. I was doing this. I wasn't exercising, this and that. I was smoking, drinking, you know, yada, yada. And I'll go through the list. And the reason I go through that list is because I know that there are things in that list that they might be practicing even in that moment, you know. And it's not to scare people. It's to make people aware that it does happen. And my experience was just waking up out of bed with a numb arm, massaging it throughout the day. That went away, but over the next couple of days, that numbness came back. So I went to Grady, and they did the test and told me that I did have a TIA stroke. It's a smaller stroke than the one that will put you in a vegetative state, but no one can determine what type of stroke they may experience. So I, in myself, am an advocate. I'm not employed by Grady Hospital, Grady Memorial Hospital, or anything like that. I don't receive anything from Grady for saying what I say, because I know that a lot of people don't get the information, you know. And if you would like to know more about stroke, just contact Grady's Stroke Center at 404-616-1111. Now, again, I don't get anything from Grady for this. They probably seen some of the hashtags like you all have seen that I put out, but there's nothing coming to me from Grady for doing this. I actually do this out of my heart, because I don't want to see people experiencing things that they don't want to experience, you know. I mean, if you're going to work and you get to the door and all your energy leaves because you've experienced a TIA stroke, what are your kids going to eat next week? You see, it's very important that we take more care of ourselves than what a lot of us have been doing, you know. So now I have a primarily, not completely, you know, I don't lie, a primarily organic non-GMO diet, okay? And that's very important, because those types, now this is my saying, this is not something that Grady is going to tell you. I feel that because of what I've learned from people like, watching videos from Dr. Sebi and, others as well, that getting, you know, certain toxins out of our system through organic non-GMO foods, that is very important. You know, so me, myself, I cut out a great deal of the meat. So now when I eat meat, it's organic, non-GMO, no antibiotics, that type of stuff. And you can tell a difference, actually. And You know, just be careful what you're putting into your mouth and into your mind, because it does show up in life, and you could save yourself a lot of heartache, you know, by being more attentive to what we eat, you know. And in all actuality, when we measure the price of organic non-GMO foods compared to conventional foods, it kind of balances out in many ways. One of those ways is when I started eating organic non-GMO, I started eating less because of budget, but also that coincided with my anatomy because I had gotten accustomed to the supersize, you know, oh, supersize drink and fry, supersize onion ring and drink, you know, whatever it was, the majority of the time I was supersizing. Well, I don't get to do that when I'm buying conscientiously these more expensive foods. They are more expensive, but when we pay more attention to what we're putting into our mouths, we eat less, you know, because our stomach is only about this big starting off, okay? This is my stomach because this is my hand, okay? So, you know, it's not like our stomachs are as big as they look to us. You know, that's just how it swells up. So a supersized meal is really like, I think now, in my thinking now, I think a supersized meal is like three times what I actually need to take in, you know, because we're not supposed to put all of that inside of us because we don't have a lot of room for it. So what does that cause for? Different type of digestion, different changes in the body that we're not paying attention to. And our bodies are always signaling us, you know, we can get a pain over here somewhere that has to deal with our stomach or anywhere, you know, because there's a brain in here, just like there's a brain in the heart. And our bodies are so intricately and just dynamic that we're always receiving communication, but a lot of the time we are not paying attention to the communication we're receiving. So please, if you'd like to know more about stroke, contact Grady Stroke Center at 404-616-1111, and they can give you documented evidence and proof and different things like the DASH diet and stuff of that nature that can help, you know, live a proactive life instead of a reactive life. Because, see, now I'm proactive in my reactiveness, but that's after the TIA, you know. So have a great day. Get some exercise. Drink good water. And be blessed. Namaste.